learn that Allah's Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam would very often give people lifts with him on the conveyance. And this is the mercy of Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and his humility. Like he had Usama radiallahu anhu with him earlier, and then Fadl radiallahu anhu. But this was always during the Hajj as well. And on certain occasions he had Uthman radiallahu anhu, and then Ali radiallahu anhu with him on his own conveyance. And throughout his life, this was always his nature. Even when he would return into Medina Munawwara, Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam would halt his camel to pick up the little children, to give them a lift and give them a ride into Medina Munawwara as they come into Medina to welcome him sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Like in the ahadith, names like Abdullah bin Ja'far radiallahu anhu took rides with Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Abbas radiallahu anhu's other children as well, Allah's Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam's own grandchildren, Hassan Hussein radiallahu anhuma, and Muawiyah radiallahu anhu. That's also an interesting report where Muawiyah radiallahu anhu was sitting behind Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and Allah's Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam asked him, "Some part of you is touching me, Muawiyah. What is it?" So Hazrat Muawiyah radiallahu anhu responded, "O Nabi of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, it would be my belly." Allah's Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam made dua for him. Allahumma amla'hu ilman wa hilman. O Allah, fill him and his belly with knowledge and forbearance with that knowledge, that he must use that knowledge wisely and with forbearance. Mu'adh radiallahu anhu as well, Abu Dharr Ghifari radiallahu anhu, Zayd bin Haritha radiallahu anhu, Dahhak bin Qais radiallahu anhu, Sharid bin Suwaid radiallahu anhu, Abdullah bin Abbas radiallahu anhuma. That's so interesting also. That incident is quite amazing, where Allah's Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam giving this young man a ride. Abdullah bin Abbas radiallahu anhu would have barely been 12 at that time. Allah's Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam gives this young sahabi, a ride with him on the conveyance and teaches him iman. So this is the humility of the Nabi of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. When he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam gets to Mina, the pelting takes place. He pelts the jamarat. Then he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam goes to make qurbani of his camels, his animals that he brought for his hajj. So Allah's Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam goes to make qurbani. 100 camels Allah's Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam brought. Some he brought with him from Medina Munawwara, and others he instructed Ali radiallahu anhu to bring on his behalf from Yemen. So Allah's Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam now sacrificed 63 camels with his own mubarak hands. Now different sahaba radiallahu anhum, Anas radiallahu anhu, Jabir radiallahu anhu, different sahaba radiallahu anhum saw the scene in different ahadith, and it's described so beautifully. Ulama explain it this way, that Allah's Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam with his own mubarak hands sacrificed 30, and then Ali radiallahu anhu came to help him with the other 33, and then the remaining amount of camels, till 100, Ali radiallahu anhu then completed for the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. According to other explanations, Allah's Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam with his own mubarak hands sacrificed 63, and afterwards he left Ali radiallahu anhu to make qurbani of the remaining 37 camels. There's one report of Anas radiallahu anhu that he sees 7 camels in front of Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. There's one report of Abu Dawood Sharif where 5 camels come towards Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. This was like one dispatch of camels, and as they are coming ahead before the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, فَاتَّفِقْنَا يَزْدَلِفْنَا إِلَيْ بِأَيِّهِنَّ يَبْدَى. The camels are hastening. Now what was happening was, all the camels were kept together, and a few at a time were presented to Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, because Allah's Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam taught us that do not slaughter and sacrifice one animal in front of the other. And Allah's Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam actually taught the ummah to not even sharpen the blade in front of the animal. Show as much of mercy as possible to the creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Yes, sacrificing the animal is something heart-rending, but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created these benefits for us. هُوَ الَّذِي خَلَقَ لَكُمْ مَا فِي الْأَرْضِ جَمِيعًا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made for you, O insan, everything that is there on this earth, for your benefit, for your service, for you to enjoy and appreciate Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's bounties. Allah's Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam sees this individual sharpening the blade in front of the animal. Allah's Nabi said sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, أَتُحِبُّ أَن تُمِيتَهَا مَوْتَاتِ وَكَمَا قَالَ النَّبِيُّ صَلَى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمُ. Do you want to inflict many deaths to the animal by instilling fear into the animal even before it has to sacrifice or be sacrificed at your hands for the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and for your benefit? In one report, Allah's Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam sees a man pulling the goat by the ear. Allah's Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, don't do it like that. خُذْ بِسَالِفَتِهَا. Hold it by the upper portion of the animal, meaning the neck, and take it along like that. Do not injure the animal by pulling the animal by the ear. In one report, one Sahabi radiallahu anhu was skinning the animal. Allah's Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, let me show you. These are few ahadith that come in Ibn Majah. Let me show you how to skin. And Allah's Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, taught him and said, هَكَذَا فَفْعَلْ. This is how you do it. In the report of Abu Dawood, these animals were rushing to be sacrificed at the hands of Janabi Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Subhanallah. Imagine the love of the animal kingdom to the Nabi of Allah, to the beloved of Allah, to Habibullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that they rush forth, that they want to be slaughtered at his Mubarak hands sallallahu alayhi wa sallam.